The broken hand, carpal metacarpal joint injuries, bossing in combat sports. Our hands are amazing instruments. They can have the precision to do surgery, the dexterity to play a musical instrument, but they can also generate tremendous force needed for rock climbing or swinging a sledgehammer. They are also clearly a weapon, and how humans almost universally use them as a fist when fighting. It is this fighting that tends to put unique forces on our hands that result in injury. I've already talked about metacarpal fractures and some details on how the hands work. You can see that separate video. This video, we're going to talk about injuries a little further down the hand, the carpal metacarpal joints. I am Dr. Lucius Pomerantz. Hands are a big part of my life. I'm an orthopedic surgeon and a specialist in the hand. I also used to punch things when I boxed and did MMA, and I still do Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. I use my hands, and I want you all to use them too. Now, for some background, carpal metacarpal joints, CMC joint injuries, have been reported to make up close to a quarter of hand injuries of elite boxers, and do account for a significant amount of time lost from training and competing. It was shown in one study that this injury resulted in the most time away from sport for amateur boxers compared to all other hand injuries. So, in today's video, we're going to talk about these injuries. Another name that some of you may know this injury as is bossing. We'll talk about this. I will talk about the anatomy of this injury, the symptoms, the causes, the treatments, and prevention of this injury. Also, as an aside, stay tuned for a separate video specific to the thumb CMC joint. It's a whole other thing. So, the anatomy, focusing in on the carpal metacarpal joints. The CMC joints are the connection between our metacarpals, the long bones of the hand, and the small wrist bones, the carpals. The most important thing to realize about the structure of this hand in this context is the second and third CMC joints, corresponding with the pointer finger and the middle finger, are set up to be very stable with minimal motion. This has been described as a fixed unit. And with stable joints, more force can go through them, which means more power can be transferred. That is the reason as to why we should be trying to land our closed fist punches on these knuckles, as opposed to the fourth and fifth. The fourth and fifth CMC joints have much more mobility. This mobility is helpful with certain tasks of the hand, but also means that they're not as stable and can be injured or even dislocated easier. We can see how this mobility at our CMC joints can shape our hand. Our hands can be positioned flat, but as we grip or make a fist, the knuckles of the thumb on one side and the ring and small fingers curl towards the index and middle fingers. Get this nice curve. So, injury. When we land a punch, the force is transmitted up the metacarpals, through the CMC joints, through the wrist, and up the rest of the arm. The wrist tends to want to collapse into flexion with punches, which creates tension at the back of the CMC joints. Whether it is one bad incident or repeated traumas over time, we see the ligaments supporting these joints tear. This results in pain. There will be swelling and tenderness. One will have difficulty with activities that put force through the CMC joints, like punching or lifting or gripping. If there is an actual dislocation, then there will be limited motion within the hand. And if you look closely, you may notice a finger is shortened or rotated without a dislocation. But with repeated trauma and worsening instability, the joint breaks down further. Eventually, you can get bone-on-bone grinding, which hurts too, and extra bone builds up in the area. Sometimes this can even be seen as large lumps that have been named bossing. The word boss comes from the French word le bossu, which means hunchback. Sometimes bossing can happen without trauma or the hobby of punching people, but it is usually not as bothersome to the patient in those situations. So, the treatment. A sprain or partial tear of the joints can be treated without surgery. This includes rest, even immobilization of the hand and wrist, anti-inflammatory medications, and sometimes corticosteroid injections. It often takes 6 weeks for things to calm down and heal. However, if the joint breaks down after repeated injuries, or if there's a really bad injury, like a dislocation, often surgery is needed. If it is a dislocation, surgeons can often reduce the bones back into place and then hold them into the right position. Other things come up with more chronic injuries that are painful. If there is bossing, the bone overgrowth is removed, but usually more is necessary, especially for the fighter who really pushes their hands. This is when surgeons often fuse the affected joints. The fancy term for this is arthrodesis. Arthrodesis is done by removing remaining cartilage or unhealthy bone to get to healthy bleeding bone. We then shove bone graft into the area, which we can get from a few places, like the iliac crest, then hold it all still with screws, plates, and or staples, while the bone then heals. Essentially, fusing the joint turns two bones into one bigger bone. This takes away the pain by eliminating the angry joint. Fortunately, most people do not notice the loss of motion at the CMC joints and can return to their normal activities. For dislocations, where the joint is reduced and held in place, it often takes about 6 weeks for the ligaments to heal and for the patient to begin more normal activities. It often takes about 8 weeks for the bones to fuse for the arthrodesis procedure. In that time, the athlete must rest the hand and wrist. Once the bone has been confirmed to have fused, activities can start. That being said, I usually tell people that the time you have been protected or immobilized is the time it takes to get the range of motion and strength back. So for this surgery, it is often 4 months before people feel more comfortable with their hand. The biggest study I'm aware of that looked at elite boxers showed that they returned to elite competition was at 8 months after surgery, though this ranged to as early as 3 months. With the second and third CMC joints fused, hand function is not compromised at all. When the fourth and fifth CMC joints are fused, one can expect slightly different function to how the hand can be positioned, but most studies show that people are able to do everything that they want to do without issue. So, prevention. One, proper technique. This means that you are landing punches on the second and third knuckles, or at least trying to. I get it. Moving targets can make this task hard to do. It also means having a straight, supported wrist when making impact. This is harder to do with certain punches, like hooks or uppercuts, but you gotta do what you gotta do. Two, hand wraps. Proper hand wrapping technique is important. Many of you develop a technique that works for you, and that's great. It does take some practice. The key is allowing a strong fist by limiting the motion at the MCP joints, the CMC joints, and the wrist. Three, allow for some rest. You can do everything right and still get some issues. Rest. Change it up. At least avoid the heavy bag or hard sparring. You can always do light pad work with good wraps on or shadow boxing, or work on some grappling techniques. By letting the tissues rest and heal, you prevent the chronic breakdown of the tissues that turn into a much bigger problem. Four, along with this, once returning to activities, it's got to be guided and slow return to sport. Do not rush things. Cross train. Not only give your body a chance to heal, but also regain motion and strength before going full speed. Lastly, five, there's the discussion of landing strikes with a different position of the hand, such as an open palm as opposed to a fist. Sure, that will certainly take forces off the metacarpals and the CMC joints. However, striking with the hand in whatever position it is in can result in injury, just different injuries. And based on much of what we see these days, it seems that the fist is an efficient and powerful tool in combat sports and will likely remain so. If you like these videos, please like, share, subscribe. I'm Dr. Lucius Pomerantz. If you take care of your body, it will take care of you. As always, let's keep moving.